What's up everybody, it's Kami and welcome to the JoJo Vento Aureo character introduction video series where I will be discussing everything about the main characters in Vento Aureo. Take this as a refresher if you've already read the manga but it's been a while, or if you're completely new to it and just want to go into the part knowing who some of these people are as just an introduction. Today we're going to be talking about one of my favorite characters in all of JoJo, Guido Mista. And of course I will be covering all the main characters in JoJo Vento Aureo, excluding the villain and a couple other people that I feel shouldn't be spoken about. But feel free to leave a vote down below in the comments for who you want to see get covered next. That being said, let's jump into the video. Guido Mista is one of the main characters in our cast of Vento Aureo, whose name is apparently a pun on mixed salad in Italian, insalata mista. Not sure what that really has to do with anything. Food jokes aside, Mista might not seem like much at a first glance, but he's truly an interesting character. For starters, looking at his design, he seems like an ordinary guy given our setting. Not sure if all Italians dress like this, but this is some high-end fashion shit that I'll never understand. Now that I think about it, he kinda reminds me of Tony the Tiger. Oh yeah, and he's paranoid of the number 4? But before joining Passione, Mista spent most of his adolescent years living a carefree life living on his own, spending his time just wandering about. Kinda reminds me of myself, except I'm not homeless, so not completely. But one night Mista gets involved in some shit, he gets shot at, and the bullets end up touching his body, and out of nowhere Mista's able to grab one of his assailant's guns, precisely killing the men that attacked him. And despite these actions being in self-defense, Mista was going to be thrown into jail until Bucciolati caught interest in him. So he used Passione's influence to keep Mista out of jail. Mista would then pass Polpo's arrow test, obtaining his stand, Sex Pistols. Now, Sex Pistols is one of the big factors that makes Mista's character stand out so much for me compared to others in the series. And Mista himself isn't necessarily the buffest dude on the planet. He's an average 18-year-old guy that's like 5'10 and weighs 150 pounds. And funny coincidence, I'm the exact same when it comes to height and weight. So I think Araki predicted me at 18, except I am not a street thug. Mista is capable of punching and kicking the shit out of people if the situation calls for it, but it's not a specialty like it is for other characters in the series like maybe Bruno or Jotaro, who just punch their way through things. Mista instead relies on his amazing skills as a marksman, and his stand perfectly complements this while providing the reader with an interesting dynamic between stand and stand user. And up until this point, we haven't seen too much of something like this, excluding maybe Echoes with Koichi. And this carries on throughout the entire part, and it's absolutely amazing to see Araki write the stand alongside Mista, almost as if they were a separate character, and not just some ability that the guy happens to have. Mista speaks to Sex Pistols often and even feeds them after battles, so he takes care of his stand. And seriously, what's there not to enjoy about this? It's pretty damn cool. Also, people seem to confuse Sex Pistols for being bullets, but they're actually just small bullet-shaped people that reload Mista's bullets for him, allowing him to reload way faster than he normally would be able to, and they can bounce bullets around for enhanced trajectory and or protection. So Sex Pistols is not the bullets, just saying. And having such an amazing synergy with his stand only makes him much more of a threat to his enemies, and when it comes to synergy, he's also really well paired with Giorno throughout the part. And throughout Vento Aureo, we see the duo working together in a lot of different situations, including some of the best moments out of the entire series in my personal opinion. Even in Mista's introductory fight against Sal, he proves to Giorno he's no pushover, and the two seem to get along fairly quickly. Mista's got a lot of loyalty for his boys, and considering the setting, loyalty and respect in the gang is the most important thing they can have. And he clearly has a lot of trust in a new guy to work so well with him in their mission to betray their boss. It's also very interesting to me that Mista is able to make decisions on the fly by himself to correlate to whatever orders or plan he might have been following prior. Like when him and Giorno fight Giacha, which I'll be talking about soon enough. But just looking at this fight, the way he just thinks on the spot, he comes up with ideas, he's fighting, he's reacting, he's doing stuff with Giorno, it's just so good. And overall, I think Mista is a big factor into what makes Vento Aureo so great in my own opinion, and I can't wait to see all of these great moments featuring him animated in October. And like I said earlier, I'll be doing more character introductions for all the Vento Aureo cast members, so be sure to subscribe to the channel. Also, follow me on Twitter at FreyKugel and on Twitch at twitch.tv/supercomicgaming. Links are in the description. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.